find somebody else's kidney and you sew them up like a rag doll and it'll just look crazy. That we might be able to just fix all those problems by fixing your DNA. And what it might mean is that the human longevity is going to increase far beyond what any of us predicted or expected. There's a fabulous article in Time Magazine, the 2045 article, and what it said was that there's this thing called longevity escape velocity. And what it means is this: right now, every 15 years, we increase the average human lifespan by about a year. But we keep having that number. And soon it's about to be 7 years. Every 7 years, we'll increase the human lifespan by a year. And then it'll be every 3.5. And then every 1.75. And in 2045, they believe we will increase the average human lifespan by a year every year.
Wow.
Which is a pretty strange thing. I mean, it sort of suggests that if you make it to 2045, you might live a very long time. And even stranger, I think, is that the scientists who were written about who produced this article just changed the estimate from 2045 to 2029.
Wow.
And so it is possible that we may only be about 12 years away, 11 years away, from longevity escape velocity. And just what it means is that we really might live a long time. We might not be like our parents. See, this chart is how long people lived. 500 years ago, everybody died at like 22 or 23. We'd all be dead probably by now. And 100 years ago, people lived to like 43. And they died from cholera and tuberculosis and things that we didn't even know existed because we didn't even believe that there were like microscopic things that were alive. And today we live to like 70 or 80. But we really might live a long time. There are scientists that think this is an exponential curve. And what that means is that we have to think about retirement differently. Because this is a chart. It's kind of an interesting chart. So every little block on this chart is a week. And this is a whole person's life in weeks. A person that lives to 90 years old. So you kind of see those early colors, that's where they're going to school. And then that whole red is their career. And then that whole purple is their retirement. I admit it's a little bit depressing when you look at it this way, right? What is that purple? It was really long. What if that purple came all the way down? You have to think about things differently. But the world is changing too. And the investments that you make back in that early stage might not work out so well in the future. I'll give you an example. True fact, the average lifespan of an S&P 500 company decreased from 67 years to just 15 years today, back in the 1920s. I mean, the S&P 500 are supposed to be the companies that last sort of forever. Even more stunning is that almost 90% of the Fortune 500 companies from 1955 are not even on the list of it. And the prediction now is that 40% of the S&P 500 will not even be on the list in just 10 years. Every month at Singularity University.